Hi students, good morning. So now in electrochemistry, continuation of remaining concepts. Last time I explained batteries, primary battery and secondary battery. Generally primary batteries are not rechargeable in nature, secondary batteries are rechargeable. Primary battery example I explained dry cell or Leclanc cell, and second one is mercury cell. Secondary battery example lead storage battery. So these are completed. Next another one is today important concept of fuel cells. What do you mean by fuel cells? Fuel cells can be defined as a galvanic cell that are designed to convert energy of fuels like hydrogen, methane, methyl alcohol converted into electrical energy are known as fuel cells. Fuel cells means a galvanic cell that are designed convert heat energy of fuels like hydrogen, methane, methyl alcohol converted into electrical energy is known as fuel cells. Best example, hydrogen oxygen fuel cells. In hydrogen oxygen fuel cells, generally carbon electrodes, the electrolyte is concentrated aqueous NaOH solution. Hydrogen gas evolved at anode, oxygen gas evolved at the cathode. Okay, carbon electrodes are act as a cathode and anode. At the cathode, oxygen gas liberated. At the anode, hydrogen gas liberated. So the fuel cells used for the production of electricity in Apollo space program. These fuel cells are used, hydrogen oxygen fuel cells. So to convert water, hydrogen oxygen converted into water. So these are hydrogen oxygen fuel cells. Now I will write fuel cell definition. Fuel cells means a galvanic cell that are designed convert energy of combustion of fuels like hydrogen, methane and methyl alcohol converted into electrical energy is known as fuel cells. Best example, hydrogen oxygen fuel cells. A galvanic cell that are designed to convert energy of combustion of fuels like hydrogen, methane and methyl alcohol converted into electrical energy is known as fuel cells. Best example, hydrogen oxygen fuel cells. Next point, these fuel cells are used for the production of electrical energy in the Apollo space program. Apollo space program. These fuel cells are used for the production of electrical energy in the Apollo space program. Apollo space program. Now I will explain hydrogen oxygen fuel cell. We know in hydrogen oxygen fuel cells, hydrogen and oxygen gas are bubbled through a porous carbon electrode in the solution of concentrated aqueous NaOH. Hydrogen gas liberated at the anode, oxygen gas liberated at the cathode. Hydrogen gas liberated at the anode, oxygen gas liberated at the cathode. Don't forget. Okay? Hydrogen oxygen fuel cells. Here, hydrogen and oxygen. Hydrogen oxygen gases are bubbled through a porous carbon electrodes in the solution of concentrated aqueous NaOH. Hydrogen oxygen gases are bubbled through porous porous carbon electrodes in the solution of concentrated aqueous NaOH, sodium hydroxide. Okay, sodium hydroxide. And another one is catalyst like finally, palladium or platinum. Finally, palladium or platinum incorporated of electrodes. To increase the rate of electrode reactions. Okay, catalyst like finally platinum or palladium incorporated of electrodes to increase the rate of electrode reactions. Generally, catalyst to palladium and platinum incorporated of electrodes to increase the rate of electrode reactions. Electrode reactions. Okay. Okay. At the cathode. Oxygen gas and at the anode hydrogen gas liberated. Now electrode reactions. At anode which gas liberated hydrogen? And anode means signaling 2H2 plus 4OH minus gives residue 4H2O plus 4 electrons. Okay, at anode reaction 2H2 plus 4OH minus gives residue 4H2O plus 4 electrons. At cathode O2 plus 2H2O 4 electrons gives residue 4OH minus. So this is your equation. Total net reaction. 4 electrons cancel. 4 electrons cancel. 4OH minus. Simply 2H2 plus O2 gives rise to 2H2O. So these are liquid. So these are gas. Simply in hydrogen oxygen fuel cells, hydrogen oxygen gas both are combined to form water. This reaction used in Apollo space program to the production of electrical energy and to the water is liberated, water is obtained. So okay, it is a vapor state. For drinking purpose, water can be used. In Apollo space program, this reaction can be used. Okay, so these are right answer and answer for yourself. Okay, hydrogen oxygen fuel cells. Now I will draw structure diagram. At the anode, hydrogen gas liberated. At the cathode, oxygen gas liberated. After that, hydrogen gas and oxygen gas combined to form water. This reaction used in Apollo space program. Apollo space program, this reaction used. So these are anode, these are cathode, these are anode, so these are cathode. Here anode which gas liberated? Hydrogen gas liberated. At the anode hydrogen gas liberated. So hydrogen oxygen fuel cell. So these are anode, cathode, water. So anode hydrogen gas liberated, at the cathode oxygen gas liberated. So the hydrogen oxygen fuel cell. Okay, these are hydrogen oxygen fuel cell. Next time hydrocarbon oxygen fuel cell. Hydrocarbon oxygen fuel cell. Hydrocarbon means alkenes. In hydrocarbon oxygen fuel cells, when hydrocarbons are burned in excess of oxygen at high temperature, produce large amount of heat. Here the electrolyte is. Here pure oxygen is acted as an oxidant. Oxidant means it undergoes reduction. Here H3PO4 acts as a electrolyte. H3PO4 acts as a electrolyte and to liberate the CO2 gas and absorbed by potassium hydroxide solution. H3PO4 acts as a electrolyte. So CO2 in combustion CO2 gas is liberated. So if hydrocarbon is burned, CO2 gas is liberated and absorbed by potassium hydroxide solution. Okay. Generally, the electrodes are platinum. Platinum electrodes are, the platinum electrodes are used. It is a costlier process. Generally, fuel cells, generally, liquid fuel cells and gaseous fuel cells. Liquid fuel cells containing methyl alcohol, ethyl alcohol and N2H4, hydrogen. Gaseous fuel cells means methane, carbon monoxide and hydrocarbons. Okay. Generally, fuel cells working below 100 degree centigrade is called. So, low temperature fuel cells. Fuel cells working so 100 to 250 degree centigrade, medium temperature fuel cells. Fuel cells working above 500 degree centigrade, high temperature fuel cells. High temperature fuel cells. Here in this fuel cells, generally oxygen, hydrogen peroxide, HNO3 used as oxidants. Okay, and platinum porous PVC, polyvinyl chloride, PTFE, polytetrafluoroethylene coated with silver act as electrodes. So these are fuel cells. So hydrogen, hydrocarbon, oxygen fuel cells. So hydrocarbon, oxygen fuel cells, when hydrocarbons are burned in excess of oxygen at high temperature, produce large amount of heat. Here fuel cells generally H3PO4 act as a electrolyte, and platinum electrodes are used. So H3PO4 act as a electrolyte. If the combustion of hydrocarbons, so to absorb the CO2 gas by potassium hydroxide solution, it is a costlier process. So now I'll write. When hydrocarbons are burned in excess of oxygen at high temperature, produce large amount of heat. When hydrocarbons are burned in excess of oxygen at high temperature, produce large amount of heat. Here the electrolyte is H3PO4, phosphoric acid. Burning of hydrocarbons produce CO2, it is absorbed by aqueous KOH solution. Platinum electrodes are used. It costlier process. Next, another one is fuel cells, liquid fuel cells, gaseous fuel cells. In liquid fuel cells, methyl alcohol, formaldehyde, hydrogen, etc. Gaseous fuel cells, hydrogen, methane, carbon monoxide, and alkanes. Alkanes formula CnH2n+2. Fuel cells, liquid fuel cells, and gaseous fuel cells. Gaseous fuel cells, hydrogen, carbon monoxide, alkanes. Alkanes formula CnH2n+2. And fuel cells working above 100 degree centigrade. So working at 100 degree centigrade, low temperature fuel cells. Above 500 degree centigrade, high temperature fuel cells. Working 100 to 250 degree centigrade, medium temperature fuel cells. Fuel cells working at 100 degree centigrade fuel cells working at 100 degree centigrade are called low temperature fuel cells. Fuel cells working below 100 degree centigrade. Below 100 degree centigrade. Above 500 degree centigrade are called high temperature fuel cells. Fuel cells working 100 to 250 degree centigrade are called medium temperature. Medium temperature fuel cells. Medium temperature fuel cells. Anyway, depends on temperature, fuel cells three types. Above 500 degree centigrade, high temperature fuel cells. Below 100 degree centigrade, low temperature fuel cells. Working between. So, fuel cells working. Working 100 to 200 to 250 degree centigrade. Working between 100 to 250 degree centigrade are called medium temperature fuel cells. Medium temperature fuel cells. Okay? In this fuel cells, another point, in this fuel cells means hydrocarbon oxygen fuel cells. Hydrocarbon oxygen fuel cells generally oxygen, air, hydrogen peroxide, HNO3 or oxidants and another one is platinum porous PORUS porous PVC polyvinyl chloride PTFE ethylenes polytetrafluoroethane are coated with silver, act as electrodes. Okay. So in hydrocarbon oxygen fuel cells. Okay, next another one is an important point. Generally in fuel cells the energy produced or electrical heat. In fuel cells, the energy produced, electrical energy produced. With efficiency of about 70%, then thermal power thermal power energy, about 40%. So in fuel cells, the energy produced, electricity, with efficiency of about 70% than thermal power energy, about 40%. So thermal power energy 40%, fuel cells energy 70%. Among these two, which one is more? So compared to thermal power energy, fuel cells produces more electricity, more energy. So that is a 70%, 40%. That is a fuel cells. Especially hydrogen oxygen fuel cells. In a fuel cells means hydrogen oxygen fuel cells generally. Okay, so these are fuel cells. Okay, only for objective, not intermediate. Only objective purpose required, not intermediate purpose. These concepts and batteries also. And the last one is corrosion. Corrosion and passivity. What do you mean by corrosion? Corrosion means the process of naturally tendency of metal converted into mineral compound with the interaction of environment is known as corrosion. The process of naturally tendency of metal into mineral compound with the interaction of environment is known as corrosion. Corrosion of iron by conversion into iron oxide, that is known as rusting. Corrosion of iron by conversion into iron oxide, it is known as rusting. Corrosion of silver by converted into silver sulfide, H2S, that is known as tarnishing. So corrosion of silver converted into silver sulfide, H2S, that is known as tarnishing. Corrosion of copper converted into copper carbonate and copper hydroxide, that is a malachite formula. Malachite. Anyway, so corrosion of iron into iron oxide, that is known as rusting. So these are corrosion. Corrosion means the process of natural tendency of metal into the process of natural tendency of metal into mineral compound. With the interaction of environment. The process of natural tendency of metal into mineral compound with the interaction of environment is known as corrosion. Example 1. Corrosion of iron by converted into iron oxide, Fe2O3. These are name hematite. Hematite is known as rusting. Iron converted into hydrated iron oxide. So that is the best example. Simply, iron converted into Fe2O3XH2, actual hydrated compound. Iron converted into Fe converted into Fe2O3XH2, rusting, hydrated compound. What do you mean by rusting? Corrosion of iron by converted into iron oxide, hematite. Corrosion of iron by converted into iron oxide. It is known as rusting. Example 1. Example 2. Corrosion of silver by. Corrosion of silver by converted into silver sulfide. Silver sulfide is known as tarnishing. Is known as tarnishing. What do you mean by tarnishing? Corrosion of silver by converted into silver sulfide. Formula H2S, that is known as tarnishing. Silver converted into silver sulfide, that is known as tarnishing. It is a one type of corrosion. Iron converted into hydrated iron oxide or iron oxide, that is known as rusting. Okay, next another one is not specific name. Corrosion of copper by converted into melachite formula CuCO3 CuOH2. These are one type of mineral. Okay, melachite, not a process. Copper converted into melachite, one type of mineral. Copper hydroxide and copper carbonate and copper. Simply, copper converted into mineral compound of copper carbonate and copper hydroxide. The compound name is melachite. Melachite is mineral name. Okay? So these are different types of corrosion. Okay. And generally, corrosion may be electrochemical or chemical process, chemical nature. Corrosion may be electrochemical or chemical nature. So generally, the anodic dissolution of metal under the conditions of corrosion is known as electrochemical or chemical nature. So corrosion may be electrochemical or chemical nature. So Corrosion may be electrochemical or chemical type. Corrosion may be electrochemical or chemical type. So the dissolution of the anodic dissolution of metal under the conditions of corrosion is known as chemical or electrochemical corrosion. The anodic dissolution of metal under the conditions of corrosion is known as chemical or electrochemical type or electrochemical corrosion. Corrosion may be chemical or electrochemical. It is two types. First, hydrogen evolution type. Second one is differential oxidation type. So the ion dissolution of metal under the conditions of corrosion is known as chemical or electrochemical corrosion. It is two types, hydrogen evolution type or differential oxidation type. So okay, electrochemical or chemical type, corrosion two types. Hydrogen evolution type, or differential oxygenation type. Hydrogen evolution means hydrogen releasing. Differential oxygenation process. Oxygen difference. Oxygen concentration less. Okay. First case. Hydrogen evolution type. In this type exhibited by metals which can displaces hydrogen from aqueous solutions. In this type metals exhibited by which can displace hydrogen gas from aqueous solutions. In this type exhibited by metals which can displace. In this type exhibited by metals which can displace hydrogen gas from aqueous solutions. In this type exhibited by metals which can displace hydrogen gas from aqueous solution. Which metals displace hydrogen gas from aqueous solution? That is hydrogen evolution type. It depends on two factors: pH of medium. Second one is chemical nature of metal undergoes corrosion. So it depends on two factors, pH of medium, chemical nature of metal undergoes corrosion. So hydrogen evolution type, we know hydrogen evolution type depends on the two factors, so pH of medium, second one is your chemical nature of metal undergoes corrosion. For example, pure zinc is dipped into the salt solution, not corroded, but in the presence of copper acts as a impurity, zinc is a corroded. And another one is when zinc rod is dipped into the two molar acid solution, it is corroded, but not in neutral salt solution. Once again, pH of medium means pure zinc does not corroded in salt solution. But in the presence of copper act as a impurity, zinc corroded. And another one is when zinc is corroded in 2-molar acid solution, but not in neutral salt solution. Because pH value more means easily. Okay, it depends on the pH of medium. For example, in this case, example, pure zinc does not corrode, but in the presence of copper acts as impurity. Zinc easily corroded. ink easily corrode. Okay, and another, when zinc dipped in 2 molar acid solution, when zinc dipped in 2 molar acid solution, or when zinc in 2 molar acid solution, easily corroded, then neutral salt solution. Okay, so pure zinc does not corrode, but in the acid solution, but in the presence of copper, act as impurity, zinc easily corrode. When zinc dipped in 2 molar acid solution, easily corroded than neutral salt solution, because pH value more, acid 2 molar means more concentration. Okay, so these are hydrogen evaluation type, this is a concept. Next, the second one is oxygen, differential oxygenation process, differential oxygenation type. Second one is differential oxygenation type. In this type, oxygen concentration is less. Oxygen concentration not uniformly distributed on the surface of the metal. In this type, oxygen concentration not uniformly distributed on the surface of the metal. In this type, oxygen concentration not uniformly distributed on the surface of the metal. For example, when iron rod is dipped into the salt solution, the immersion part is easily corroded because concentration of oxygen is not uniformly distributed on the surface of the metal. For example, if iron rod dipped into the salt solution, the iron rod immersed. Okay. The iron rod immersed into the salt solution. The immersion parties easily corroded due to oxygen concentration less. That means not easily distributed on the surface of the metal. That means not easily distributed on the surface of the metal. Not easily distributed on the surface of the metal. Okay, so these are. And another example. But copper easily corrodes zinc. because zinc has more anodic than copper. Among two metals, which metal has more anodic than easily corroded? Copper, COBBR. Copper easily corrodes zinc. Because zinc has more anodic than copper. And or copper favors. Because zinc has more anodic than copper. And another one is iron disfavors the corrosion of zinc. Iron disfavors the corrosion of zinc, that is a alloy. This is a galvanization. Galvanization is painting. We know iron, rod is there, zinc coating used because prevention. That means that is known as galvanization. What is meant by galvanization? Simply alloying of. So the coating of zinc on the surface of the iron is known as galvanization. Galvanization means the coating of the surface of the iron with zinc, metal is known as galvanization. So iron disfavors the corrosion of zinc. Zinc. Zinc disfavors the corrosion of iron. Because galvanization. We are using iron rods. Iron rods is there. In iron rod surface, we are using zinc coating. That is known as galvanization. So zinc disfavors the corrosion of iron. That is a galvanization. So these are all prevention of corrosion. How can prevent the corrosion? Prevention methods of corrosion. First one is alloying. Second one is galvanization. Galvanization means used zinc coating. So alloying, galvanization. And another one is painting. Next another one is covered surface by some chemicals. Example, bisphenol. Covered surface by some chemicals. Example, bisphenol. And another one is coating metals by coating of surface by other metals. Like tin, zinc, etc. Covered surface by some chemicals. Example, bisphenol. coating of surface by other metals. Coating of surface by other metals like tin and zinc. So these are prevention of corrosion. Prevention of corrosion. Okay, students. Okay, nearly 45-50 minutes completed. So these are corrosion concept completed. Remaining last concept, very small concept, passivity. Passivity next class I will explain. Passivity next class I will explain. Okay, so these are today what I am explained concepts in IITG NEET for required, but in intermediate purpose not there. Batteries, fuel cells, corrosion in intermediate point of view this year due to COVID-19 they deleted, but objective point of view required. Okay, so these are corrosion, fuel cells. So types of fuel cells I explained. So remaining last concept, just half an hour, 20 minutes enough. Remaining last concept, passivity, next class I will explain. Okay, my dear students, thank you for all.